The subprocess module provides a lot of features to execute external commands. In this tip, we'll see how to capture output. Consider this external command to be executed. The first way to capture output is using the subprocess.run method. First, you pass the command to be executed, and then you set capture_output to true. We are also setting text equal to true because by default you will get the output in bytes. The output of subprocess.run is a completed process object from which you can get details like what is the exit status, what is the standard output, and what is the standard error. The second way to capture output is by using subprocess.checkOutput method. So you pass the command and then set text equal to true. Let us see another example. In this case, the output is going to generate an error because xyz.txt does not exist in this particular directory. So if you use the checkOutput method, we'll get an exception because the exit status is not zero for this particular command. If we use the subprocess.run method, you will see the exit status in this return code parameter, and you will see the std error showing what went wrong with this command. Hope you enjoyed this tip.